I've been watching, you know, state media and listening to conservative media all day because I, you know, I want to hear the other side. And I was like, I don't understand why this is a story. How is she supposed to know who's on the other side of the door? How is she supposed to know how many people were on the other side of the door? I'm just saying, there's nothing to do with anything AOC or whatever. But how I kept trying to figure out how the people who were actually involved in that siege and all the chaos could be criticizing someone else who was involved in it because she was explaining how what she thought was going on in her particular situation, it was just flat out partisanship and a distraction to Marjorie Taylor Greene.
They're going after one of the Democrats because the Democrats going after one of theirs. I'm telling you, Mr. Noise Pollution over there at State TV and the others, they want to frame the Democrats for January 6th. They've been leaking it out all these different ways that there's an untold story, that this was a setup. It's all BS.
Let them do it.
And their toxicity. And I'll tell you what, you just heard Katie Porter say AOC was freaked out.
Yeah.
And let me tell you, I lived a situation like that. And it doesn't have to be real, the threat, for you to believe it's imminent.
You believe. And let me tell you something. Let them do it because they look like idiots in the process and people are on to it.
So no more than any other time.